time to a video editor, is there anything more precious? We spend so much of it just working on basic things, which is why I want to give you 6 tips which can help speed up your workflow. My name is Chad. I make DaVinci Resolve tutorials and create systems and processes to help speed up your workflow. So if you're finding this information is useful to you, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe. Let's jump on in and see how to do it. So let's get started here in the edit page. And the first thing we want to talk about is timelines. They're so important. And maybe you're only used to using one, maybe you're used to using a couple of them or whatever, but I'm going to show you how to manage them really easily and how to move through them very quickly. These can really save you a lot of time. What we need to do is come all the way to the top left and click on Media Pool. And as you can see, under my master bin, I have created another bin, which is specifically just for the timelines. As you can see, I have a lot of stuff going on there with a lot of timelines. Now, additionally, over here, we only see one. But what we can do is underneath of our video viewer, you come down and go over to the left here, and you can see just above the timeline, like right down below here where you have your transform and all that. I have Fusion Overlay selected right now. But below that, you have this little icon, and this is actually your timeline's view options. So let's go ahead and click that and see what we have here. There are so many things. So if you do like a subtitle tracks, you can turn that on and off right here. Display your audio waveform. So let me click that. As you see, the audio waveforms disappeared. You have so much control there. So, but what we're going to do on this is put display stacked timeline. Once that clicks, look at that. All of my timelines have just popped up. So as you can see, this was the project that I was working on before, but anytime that I was editing it, I would make a copy of it. So once I had the whole thing cut, I made a copy. Once I had all of these adjustment clips, which had the little pop-out windows that highlight the things for me to show you, well, I make a copy of that timeline and I keep progressively making more and more every time I make a change. This way, if I mess something up or I don't like it, I can just go right back to what it was. That being said, we can do so much more with that too. So maybe you edit shorts or something. I'm just gonna take a random thing. I'm not doing anything specific. And I'm gonna create some in-out points. So I'm just gonna select this part. I'm gonna put in, and I'm gonna come over here, and I'm gonna press O for out. So we have I for in, O for out. And say we're gonna make a short using that. We're gonna need a new timeline. So what you can do is press Command or Control N, and then this information will come up. So what I'm gonna do is change this to shorts. All right, so maybe we're doing a short. Down here in the bottom left, it says use project settings. Well, we don't wanna use that because we're using a 16:9, right? So we want a 9:16. So we're gonna click that, we're gonna change this. Under general, this is what we had. Now we're gonna go over to format. So here, as you can see, I'm doing 4K. I'm just gonna click on use vertical resolution, and I'm gonna press create. Now that I've created that, and I can go back to where I was at, and I can take what I had selected there. I can Command C that, come back over to that timeline, press Command V. And now, boom, I have everything that I just selected from this timeline over here. So just like that, you can easily move things between one timeline to the other. Next thing we're gonna stick onto that kind of topic is we're gonna do the same thing, but we're gonna do it with multiple projects. For example, on this timeline here, you see, let me press Shift A, that way I get everything selected. You can see, like, I have my music, I've got my other stuff. So as I have all this stuff already available, like all this music and stuff, so let's imagine this project, I didn't have any of that music in there, but I wanted to get it in, from another project that I had done already. That way I don't have to cut it all up and everything else. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna come down here to the bottom right here, next to project settings. There's this little home icon, project manager. If I click that, okay, so then this will pop up here. And what you can do is you can right click on it and come down here. It says dynamic project switching. So let's select that. Now I'm gonna right click again just to show you. Now you see there's a little check mark there. What that means is that any projects that I open during this time, I'll be able to switch between project to project, just like we did timeline to timeline. So let me go to power bins. So now under this power bins, you see I already have all this music laid out. All I gotta do is go ahead, select that, Command C. Okay, now I wanna go back to the other project. Instead of coming all the way back here and selecting this and finding the project and doing all that, all I have to do is come all the way to the very top in the middle. And you see where this says power bins, which is this project. Now it has a little drop down icon. So let me click on that and you can see multicam, which was the previous project I was in. So if I click that, and now it will load this project. And if I go to a timeline that I want to put that music on, I just press Command V and boom, now I have all of that music already cut up the way I like, and now I can go readjust it and make it how I want to do. Super simple, very easy to flow through. Okay, so the next really good tip is power bins. Yeah, I'm just going to briefly touch on this. If you want to see the full overview video, go ahead, check that video I've linked above and you'll be able to see that. But for right now, let's get into just regular power bins. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new bin in my power bins. I'm going to right click new bin and I'm just going to put this one as highlight. So now I have this one. It's called highlight. As you see, it's empty. What I'm going to do is, because in a lot of my videos, I'm consistently using an adjustment clip that I have set up that has these different sections that I highlight and bring out, you know, these pop-out windows for you to be able to view, just like as you can see here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab this adjustment clip, I'm going to drag it into there, and then I'm going to rename this as bottom LPO for pop-out, okay? So we have the bottom left pop. Now, let me come over and find another one. What I can do to look through all the different adjustment clips when I'm doing that, so I can just click on it and see where does it go. So now I see this is top right, okay, well, I'm just going to grab that one and drag it to there, and I'm going to rename this one as pop RPO for pop out. So now the point is, say if I go into another timeline and I need a pop out on the top or on the bottom or the top or something, I can just go ahead, set that in where I want, and then I can go ahead and make all the adjustments to that as needed and speed up so much time. For the next tip, we're going to go into the color page. So come on down here to the bottom, click on color. As you can see, I just have one lonely node over here and nothing's going on. So this one is about power grade. If you want to learn how to make the node tree, you can go ahead and check the video I link above here. And this one is all about creating your node tree, which is really simple, especially for YouTube. To get to power grades, we're going to come all the way to the top left. I'm going to click on gallery. And once that gallery comes up, you see we have these over here. There's one is for stills. This has timeline stuff, but that power grade, that is just like the power bins, except for color grading. So I can put whatever color grades I make inside of here, I can save it into a power grade bin and then just put that right onto the clip. So let's take a look and see what we have here. I have several different power grades for different situations, depending on the colors and the lighting that I was using. So for example, this one is completely blank. So if I wanted to start from scratch, I can just right click this one, apply grade. So once you apply that, then here is what I would have, is this node tree automatically build out, and then I can begin the adjustment, or I can save the adjustment too. So let's see, as you can see, I have some that are graded already and I can choose whichever one I would like. So for example, maybe I want to use, all right, so I'll apply the grade from here. Let's see how that looks, and it looks horrendous. So depending on what it is, whether or not it's going to work, let me apply this grade. So when you're applying grades like this, this is not like applying a LUT. This is actually applying a color grade before you would put a finishing LUT if that's what you wanted to do. So the next thing that I want to show you is doing exactly that. So maybe you want an overall LUT and you can create your own super easy, or you can just apply some. But let me show you how to do it really simple. What we're going to do is we're going to add an adjustment clip. Go into the effects, click on that. We're going to come down to our effects here, or you can search for adjustment clip. And I'm going to put that all the way up here on the top on a video layer of its own. All right, so I need to zoom in here for a second. That way we can extend that a bit. I'm going to bring it up. Now I can go ahead and grab that. I'm going to just drag this all the way across to the end. Now I have this and it goes across the entire project, which means that whatever I choose to do with this is going to apply to the entire timeline. So let's go back to the color and say you want to grab that node, go up to your effects, and let's do the film look creator. So I start typing a film, find the film look creator, select that. Now I have a film look creator. It's not a good spot. Let me find a good spot here. Yeah, we'll go with that. Back onto the color page. So that's where we're looking at there. And now in the beta 5 of DaVinci Resolve 19, we can go and check different things here. They have cinematic, Rochester, Alaska, elated, vintage, cinematic. All right, so we'll just stick with cinematic, and then you can make your adjustment. So maybe you just didn't want to do that. You just want to right click, reset node grade. All right, so let's go up here under LUTs. So maybe you want want to look for some film looks, okay? So you can easily just go ahead and find the film look you want, grab that, drag it on there, and now you have that film look for the overall thing, and you can start making any adjustment you want from there. The last tip I have for you in speeding up your edit is learn some keyboard shortcuts or learn how to use this mouse. If you want to learn how to go over those specifically in detail, go ahead and check the link above for that video. But let me just show you some quick things that you can do with, say, an editing mouse like this. You can easily go to any section where you want, select your clip, and just click a button, and as you can see, that is now cut. Or maybe if you're somewhere's over here and you don't want anything from this point until the end, there's this little button on the side, and I just click that and it ripple deletes it. Or I need to ripple delete from there, and I can ripple delete there. Also, other things that I can do is, like, if I'm working here and I need to move all of this stuff out of the way instead of going and selecting all of this kind of thing, what I can do is just click this one button and boom, it selects everything from the part of that playhead all the way to the end, and I can easily move it out. Save so much time, be able to edit really quickly. Now, there's also all of those on the keyboard shortcuts, and they're totally free. If you're not sure what your keyboard shortcuts are, very easy to find them. You can come up here to where it says DaVinci Resolve, go down to keyboard customization. If you are using a Mac, this can be extremely helpful as well. If you come over here to where there's help, if you're not sure where something is, but you want to look for it, start typing it under help. If you're using a Mac, it's really good. So let's check out those keyboard shortcuts again. So let's start typing keyboard. Now you can see it's coming up there, keyboard customization. I'm just going to hover over that, and you see on a Mac, it will just create this little thing to hover over there and show you exactly where that is. And you can click on that and brings up your keyboard customization. However, I do want you to understand it is a little bit confusing looking through here. This is stuff for edit. This is for trimming. So if you're looking for trimming things, you know, like trim to start, the trim mode, and different things like that. So they are some of the tips I have for you to speed up your workflow. I hope you find that information is useful. And please remember to subscribe and check one of these videos out here to help further your abilities in DaVinci Resolve. And I'll see you in the next one.